hadn't expected this to happen.
What do you mean?
I didn't expect the things to go so rapidly.
I suppose there'll be a post-mortem.
Of course. That's what his doctor wants.
Why the special branch here?
I asked him to look round.
Why? Do you think he was killed?
No, of course not. His liver was in a shocking state.
Well, I don't understand what they're after.
Just a security check, Castle.
Here's another one. The same vertical line down the margin. She should never have looked at me if she meant I should not love her.
I need some air.
So does Bullock.
Darling, don't let's tell Sam yet about Davis. Not while he's still finding his feet at school.
Oh, you know best.
Poor Davis. No more hide and seek.
Yes, no more hide and seek. Come on, Bullock.
Straight from home to the funeral.
Damnation, this is for Section 6.
But I managed to catch Mr. Castle. He's outside now.
Oh, yes, get him. We've had a death in the family.
I'm sorry. Who is it?
A chap called Davis. Well, Mr. Muller has just returned from Germany. Thank you for coming over at such short notice. Now, Castle, sorry to make you miss the funeral. I want you to cover this for Watson, all right?
Of course.
Well, far away. No notes, gentlemen.
Thank you. This is an off-the-record briefing about an operation known as Uncle Remus. The first thing to say is that Uncle Remus is not an operation to defend South Africa for its own sake, but to defend the Free West. This is certainly understood in Washington, from where Sir John has just returned. If the gold mines were ever closed by a racial war, Russia would be the chief source of gold. And for all of us, it would make the oil crisis look like a minor inconvenience. Not just gold, diamonds, uranium. And if it was a losing war, as in Vietnam, well, you can see, it's a worrying picture.
I can't believe they'd get involved again. I mean, with the troops in a strange continent. Well, they're just as ignorant of Africa as they were of Asia.
Uncle Remus would make the use of troops almost unnecessary. The plan is, in the event of invasion,
to seal South Africa off from the north, leaving a narrow channel where the enemy can be met and stopped.
How? You've got a long, open frontier. Too long for minefields. You're going to build a wall?
An invisible wall, yes. The careful use of technical weapons in desert country would make such a wall.
Tactical?
It's a reassuring word. The technical bomb was reasonably clean. Much cleaner than the bomb at Hiroshima.
Jesus Christ.
Now, Mr. Castle, I was hoping you would call in. I have the trollop for you. My son says you will enjoy this one very much.
I was thinking of dropping in to see your son. Would I find him in?
You won't, sir. Not now. Anything I can tell him?
It's a rather delicate matter. I have a number of books at home, you know, bought in my youth. Illustrated books of the kind your son may be interested in. And it struck me that, you know, some of them might be worth quite a lot of money. And, well, you know how it is. I've brought a list with me.
I'll make sure he gets it as soon as he's back.
That's very kind of you.
And what about The Way We Live Now?
The Way?
The book by Trollope.
Do you mind if I don't bother after all? I need a rest from all that.
Yes, fine. Thank you. Hold on a minute. Here. Get out. Yes? Fine, it's all right.
Remember poor Davis?
You know nothing about Davis.
Put some soda in.
Look, don't mother me, Sarah. I don't want to be looked after. I'm sorry.
Something has happened. Why can't you talk to me? Because they forbid it? The Official Secrets Act and all that stupidity?
It's not them. When we came to England, Sarah, Connolly sent someone to see me. He had saved you and Sam. All he asked for in return was a little help. I was grateful, and I agreed.
What's wrong with that?
I've been a double agent for 7 years. There. I've waited all that time to tell you.
Yes. Are you in danger?
I've always been in danger.
Now, tonight?
It's worse now. I think they've discovered there's a leak, and I think they thought it was Davis.
You think they killed him?
Yes.
So it might have been you?
Yes.
How did they know about the leak?
Well, they must have a defector somewhere in Moscow who had access to my reports and passed them back to London.
That means you're safe. If you stop now, it will confirm that Davis was the leak. I mean...
I know. I told Connolly's man I was finished. I said goodbye to the whole thing. And then something else happened. It dropped into my lap like a gift from God, or more like a joke from God. The biggest secret I've ever been trusted with. Because Watson happened to be at a funeral.
What are you talking about?
I had to let them know what those bastards are up to. I hope I have. I don't know.
Morris, it's suicide. Now that Davis is dead, when your report's passed back to London...
I know, but it may save a lot of lives. Lives of your people.
Don't talk to me about my people. You are my people. What do you want me to do?
Well, the best thing would be for you to take Sam and go to my mother's. Separate yourself from me for a while. Pretend there's been a bad quarrel. If nothing happens, I'll stay here and we'll come together again.
And if something does happen?
Well, they've promised me an escape route. Alone. And then they'd contact you and Sam when everything dies down. We wouldn't be able to communicate. Perhaps for a long time. You haven't said a word of blame, Sarah.
What would I say?
Well, I'm what's commonly known as a traitor.
We have our own country. You and I and Sam. And you've never betrayed that. How long do we have?
I don't understand why you've jumped to such a conclusion.
Well, something kept bothering me after my evening with Castle. Later, I realized what it was. It was the way he took the news of Connolly's death.
Connolly was a friend of his.
A communist friend.
It was his job to make communist friends.
I wasn't seriously alarmed. I simply made a mental note that there, if was ever a leak in the African section, it would be Castle.
Interesting.
And then came the funeral. A chap called Davis, you said.
Davis died of cirrhosis.
Yeah, so you said. And Connolly died of pneumonia. I will only say one thing, Sir John. If there has been a leak in the African section, I tell you with utter certainty that the leak is Castle.
Well, as I say, there has been no leak. We've simply lost a good man who liked port a little too much.
I hope to God you're telling the truth.
This is my house, Mr. Muller.
I mean no offense. We both have to tell lies from time to time. I just hope that for you, this isn't one of those times. Good night.
Hello?
Ah, is Mr. Halliday there?
No. But this is Mrs. Halliday.
My name's I'm a customer.
Yes, Mr. Castle.
Well, I wanted to ask him about a letter.
I've no idea when he'll be back.
Oh, where is he?
He had to go to court.
Court?
They arrested our son, you see.
Arrested him? I thought the police had come to an understanding with your son.
That's what he thought till 6 o'clock this morning. Wicked, isn't it?
Sorry. I thought we had time. I was wrong. You'll have to take Buller.
What will you do?
I've got a number for abandoned ship. I don't know if it still works. Either they'll help me to get out, or the police will come.
Then it's the end for us.
Of course it's not the end. As long as we're alive, we'll come together again.
I spoke to your mother. She wasn't exactly welcoming.
Now, if nothing happens, you'll come back, okay?
And if?
Well, you came to the Falona Hotel, remember?
Yes.
Goodbye, Daddy.
Goodbye, sir. I'll see you soon. Come on.